अरे मैडम सर देखते हो ना, आपका ही फेस दिख रहा ज्यादा।
अरे मैं तो बोलूंगा चलो बेटा।
Yeah, I watch little things, but it's a nice show. I think both of them, Dhruv and Mithila, girl YouTube together.
Coming out in the second.
Yeah, on Netflix. Right? Yeah, big, that's a big thing. Like,
you are also
Netflix. Yeah, I'm sure. For me, just I feel like right now it's just date kind of handling multiple industry.
We need to make.
Yeah, and I feel like Netflix. Maybe one more thing. It doesn't matter. And then they cut it down to 2.5 hours, which means I've lost half of my shoot time, half of the content I shot, half of my scenes, songs, everything. So sometimes I feel like maybe a Netflix kind of format, you don't want to lose all the shoot. A lot of the times when we shoot now, like I don't, after a scene I try not to get attached to it. Because you never know if you get cut. Many a times I've been very sad about the scene. Nowadays I feel the same, I'm like, forget about it. It's there good if it's not there. But in a format like Netflix, that issue is not there.
मेरे को भी देख।
I think my all of my growing up we used to keep driving from Kochi, one coast of India to Chennai, another. Because we lived in Chennai, but my father predominantly worked in Kerala. So there was a lot of fond memories. It happened very often. Good days, good times, road trips. I've always imaginary plans, but it never happens. Work just keep getting. So every year, like these plans keep happening in my head. I'm like, August I'll do this, December I'll do this. Nothing.
So any plans for why you could get
also? Actually, yeah, I've been traveling a lot. Right? But so I worked like a year and a half nonstop. Like my wife can see. Got anyway, we can't travel as a couple. So I just took on all the work that came my way and I was working on stuff. So I think on my road was about 5 months old, we started traveling a lot. So last year I did around November, December, I did like Dubai, Thailand, Hong Kong, Sri Lanka, with the baby. It was a lot more tiring than you think.
So what about your dad when you were young? Your dad
used to he used to.
Because he's a
superstar. But annually every year, like every year, he made sure he found it. I got to New York like early morning, like we used to leave father, daughter, coffee, early morning. My wife was about to come here. So I put on the scooter and I'll make sure that I like my coffee. I'll go buy coffee. So I'll give her like a straw. By the time I get my coffee, she's eating like half the paper. And then I'm like, is she behaving differently? Does she look like she's in some kind of stomach pain? And I don't tell my wife. And then I'll be observing her for the rest of the day. I'm like, you know what, something happened this morning. I think she's borrowed a bit of paper. But I feel like as dad, like, you know, we do make silly mistakes. But yeah, but she's a bit of a trooper, I think. My daughter, like, this. Throughout my wife's pregnancy, she was supposed to be a boy. Yeah, they kept saying she was a boy. And then C-section. Suddenly the doctor was like, you know, what do you think it is? So we're like, they know it's a boy. And they're like, don't go out of the jungle. And so I look, I'm not, I'm so disoriented. I said, yeah, it's a boy. I just wasn't paying attention, and I really want a girl. And suddenly the doctor is like, it's a girl. So I start screaming and shouting in the OT, all this stuff. And then everybody, all the whole family was outside, they thought something bad happened. So everybody started panicking. And then so I ran out and I was like, I told you. And then I ran back inside. I didn't tell them what happened as a boy and girl.
Why is it not expecting a boy?
They named the boy.